from Maleme to Chania, supported by the constant bombing of the German Air Force on artillery positions and troop movements, the defender dodged to the east. May 23, fourth day of the attack. The New Zealanders' nocturnal retreat did not go unnoticed, and the German decided to attack Pladanias immediately. Here the enemy has taken a strong position on the ridges. In this course of action by the Germans on the coastal strip, countless unusable guns fall into their hands and take over two main association posts of the New Zealanders with the medical staff. The attack by the Germans comes to a standstill in the strong defensive fire of the defenders in Pladanias.
Die Deutschen nutzen nun den feindfreien Flugplatz von Maleme und landen pausenlos Material und Gebirgsjäger aus. Sogar die Jagdflugzeuge bleiben jetzt stationiert. Angesichts des am nächsten Tag des 24. Mai zu erwarteten Großangriffes der Deutschen auf die Riegelstellung und schließlich die Führung der Griffors im Schutz der Dunkelheit auf die Hügelkette westlich von Chania bei Galatas zurückzugehen.
On the attack front in front of Galatas, the German troops have taken up their starting positions. Before the start of the major attack, it rained bombs on the enemy positions all morning on May 25th. Then, in the afternoon at 4:30 p.m., another bomb attack by German planes on the New Zealand positions.
17 Uhr, Angriffsbeginn der deutschen Fallschirmjäger und Gebirgsjäger.
But the British Lion shows its teeth. Here the enemy stands in his system of positions, shiny camouflage in numerous nests of resistance. At Pladanias, 2 kilometers before Chania, the left wing of the combat group stops on the coast. They come across a large camp of a British field hospital, with a large number of wounded and medical personnel.
Das Gefängnis von Chania. Gefechtsstand Oberst Heydrich und Feldlazarett Walter Kämpfe. Thank you.
After the British lost the heights of Gallatas, the Germans still have to master all their strength to blow the last locking bar in front of the island capital of Crete, Chania, and are on the heels of the retreating enemy on the morning of May 26th. The place Tarazos is occupied by the mountain troops, then Perivolia by the paratroopers.
Hier rund Galatas, Schauplatz heftigster Kämpfe. Hier nochmals in der Ferne das Gefängnis. Gefechtsstand Oberst Heidrich.
On May 26th, General Freyberg decided, after long struggles with his commanders and the top leadership in Alexandria, to retreat and to evacuate the island. After the parrier to Galatas was abandoned, Freyberg considered the Battle of Crete to be lost. In the evening, a New Zealand and Australian brigade moved into a new position on a line known as 42nd Street, west of Suda Bay. So much resistance had to be offered until the evacuation of the British troops from the island was initiated and secured. The paratrooper memorial on Crete was erected after the victorious Operation Merkur, the conquest of Crete from 20th to 28th May 1941, near the former capital Chania, for the fallen of the 2nd Battalion of Airborne Storm Regiment 1. In the course of time, it developed into a memorial to all German paratroopers and is known far beyond Europe's borders. Since the winter of 21, the eagle on the base of the monument has been missing due to storm damage. It is also said that the eagle was deliberately destroyed. For many years, the memorial has been repeatedly damaged by left-wing extremists, graffiti on the base, and maliciously desecrated. The memorial is called the German Bird in Crete, which is also the name of the nearest bus station. The Paratrooper Association had tried to maintain the memorial for Elise until 24. But the high monetary demands for a further lease, as well as the dizzying purchase price for the purchase of the site, are now driving the monument into demolition.